Okay, so here we go on part two. I've got our switch list in hand. So what we're going to do in this section is we're going to get our train built up and work our way over to the brewery plant. On the very back track here, the back three boxcars there are the bottom three on this list. And then this hopper and these two boxcars are first three on our list. And then these four DSDX reefers are the middle four cars. So we're gonna go ahead and build our train. Okay, let's go ahead and fire up the locomotives. Okay. Now we're going to back up to the yard lead here at Humboldt and grab our first cut of cars. Turn out. Okay, I'm gonna come back on a couple. Now we're going to go ahead and park these three cars here, which are the back three cars of the train. I'm going to disconnect those using a skewer, and I go down between my coupler knuckles. I don't have trip pins. We're going to go back and get our reefers. A lot of bell ringing in urban railroading. Okay. missed a couple there. I'm not trying to run. My coupler's up. But it's been up sometimes. Now. Go ahead and grab our transfer caboose. Okay, we're going to go ahead and start our journey south to the brewery plant. Train here at crossing. Cars in the train are lined up for our switch list. So as our train's approaching, our first order of business is we're going to pull these three grain empties or malt empties out, swap them for the first three that's in our train, which is just now arriving. By the way, our locomotives are FM H1044, 772, and 780. 780 is my only factory painted Corvax Morph switcher from the original Walker's Proto run. 772 is a custom paint. Both units have Tsunami 2 sound decoders and sugar cube speakers. Okay, let's pull these empties. from our turnout. You're it. So, you know, since we're going to be in the street. I don't necessarily be able to wait for like the air to pump up and such. I'm not quite that hardcore in the operations. Here comes our empties. I'm going to go forward for crossing this second. Go get the rest of our train and pull it forward a little bit. Okay. We're about to pull this much. And we got that grain hopper as the first car, so he has to be spotted at that front spot with grain elevator. By the way, the box car behind it is from my last weathering video, in case you care to know. Okay, that's good. We're going to cut off at the reefers here. We're going to shove our three loads in so they can start unloading while we switch the sea house. Here we go. Okay, I want to go ahead and give you this peek down inside the malt silos here, the Schlitz grain A elevator. And you can see the grating. We always have spot covered hoppers over that. However, then you got doors, three spots of those. That's where your grain boxes go. And they just push the grain out of the boxcar through those doors and a conveyor would carry it up into the elevator. In real life, you would actually have a brakeman hanging off the front car. Send signals back in case it needs to stop since you're going through the street. And push them in nice and easy. Okay. We're going to go get rid of these boxcars up in the siding. That's where these guys are. So as you can tell in this spot, this is nothing more than just a passing siding. Gives me a place for trains to meet, get cars out of the way, so it makes my switching easier to do. Goes across the window. Just nothing more than a basic scenic board with track. And get back onto the main part of the layout here. Okay, this concludes this segment of the ops session. To keep the video from being too awfully long, I'll divide this session into two parts as well. So basically, this is part two. We'll have part three in the next video, and I hope you'll join me for that. We'll finish out this job and pull out the beer loads, pin it these in, and switch the grain elevator again. Anyway, but thanks for watching, and I look forward to next time.